A very good morning, myself Virendra Kumar Maurya, Associate Professor, Department of Electrical Engineering, School of Engineering, Babu Banarsi Das University, Lucknow. I welcome all of you in this video lecture. This lecture is based on network theorems. Theorems are used to solve the problems in a very easy way. In that we can save time. Here in this lecture I'm going to discuss regarding Norton's theorem. Please see on the board. Now the theorem is Norton's theorem. Norton's theorem. Right? What is the Norton's theorem? There is a complex network. Right? This one is a complex network. And load is connected in between point A and B. This one is the load RL. Right? What is the Norton's theorem? Any complex network is reduced into a simple network containing a current source, Norton's equivalent resistance in parallel, right? And these are the two points A and B. A resistance RL is connected over here. Right, so this portion is known as the Norton's equivalent portion, or you say Norton's equivalent circuit. Right, any complex network is reduced into a simple network, into a simple circuit containing of current output IN in parallel with RN, that is Norton's equivalent resistance. Right, this circuit, right, this circuit in between this dotted portion is known as the Norton's equivalent circuit. Norton's equivalent circuit. Right, now the procedure of Norton's theorem. See, first of all, remove the load resistor and put a short circuit across it. Then calculate short circuit current, that is IN. Second, for the calculation of RN, remove the load resistor first and voltage source is shorted and current source is opened. If they are non-ideal, then sources are replaced with their internal resistance. Right, now the resistance viewed from the load side is known as RN, that is Norton's equivalent resistance. Now connect IN, RN and RL in parallel. This one is known as the Norton's equivalent circuit. Right, where IN is Norton's equivalent current, RN Norton's equivalent resistance and RL is the load resistor. Now see the circuit diagram very carefully. IN, RN and RL, these three are connected in parallel. This one is known as the equivalent circuit diagram of Norton's theorem. Right? Now the current in the load resistor, that is IL, is equal to IN in bracket RN divided by RN plus RL. Right, this is the simply current division by which we can calculate the current through the load resistor. This one is a voltage source, right, having the value V. These are the resistances connected over here.
having the values of R1, R2, R3 and R. This one is the load resistance R in between points A and V, right? See the Norton's theorem over here. This circuit is reduced into a simple circuit containing IN, right? And a resistance that is RN along with RL, which is the load resistor in between point A and B. All these three are connected in parallel, right? Now our task is how to calculate RN and IN. So see first calculation of RN. Calculation of RN, which is known as the Norton's equivalent resistance. What is the procedure? Number one, all the ideal voltage sources are short circuited. If there is any ideal current source, then that one is open circuit, right? And remove load resistor. Load resistor is removed. Here resistance R3, R2 and R. Whatever the resistance viewed from this side is known as the Norton's equivalent resistance. How can we calculate? That one is nothing but parallel combination of 1 and 3, 1 and 3 is in series with R2. That's why this is the value of Rn, right? Now the calculation of In. In. See, this one is the voltage source. These are the resistances. R1, R2 and R3. What is the procedure? Remove the load resistance and then whatever the current passing through this short circuit line is known as IN, right? How can we calculate? See, this one is your current I1. So first of all, calculate I1, then after with the help of current division rule we can calculate I. So the value of I1 or I, that is voltage divided by equivalent resistance. What is equivalent resistance? It is R1 plus parallel combination of 2 and 3. Right? This is the value of I. Now In is equal to total current into R3 divided by R3 plus R2. This is the current division rule. With the help of current division rule we can calculate the value of In, right? Now we can put these two values In and Rn. Then after we can apply a formula, current passing through this load resistor that is IL is nothing but In into Rn divided by Rn plus Rn. This is the required formula, final required formula for the calculation of load current in load register, right? This is all about the Norton's theorem. This is the example based on Norton's theorem, right? This one is the voltage source having the value of 20 volt. These are the resistances 10 ohm, 10 ohm and 10. This one is load resistor having the value of 5. What is our task? Our task is to calculate the load current IL through the load resistor by the Norton's theorem, right? Okay, to solve this problem with the Norton's theorem, it is necessary to convert it into a Norton's equivalent circuit, that is IN, so RN. These two are connected in parallel along with load resistor R, right? First of all, calculation of R. Calculation of R, right? What is the procedure? All the voltage sources are short circuited and current sources are open circuited, and remove the load resistor and viewed it from the load side, right? There are three resistances and they are belonging to the 10 ohm each. What is the value of Rn? Rn is nothing but 10 parallel with 10, and this combination is in series with 10, right? These two 10 ohm resistors are connected in parallel, then after series with this 10. So it is 5 plus 10, that is 15 ohm, right? Now the calculation of IN. How can we calculate IN? There is a procedure. What is the procedure? Remove the load resistor. Okay. These are the resistances. Point A, it's point B. Right? I have removed it and these two points are short circuited. Then whatever the current passing through this short circuit line is known as IN, right? This one is 20 volt, current over here is I, and these are belonging to the 10 ohm each. Okay, first of all calculate I, that is nothing but 20 divided by equivalent resistance. These two are connected in parallel, then after series with 10, it become 15, right? That is 4 upon 3 ampere. Now IN, IN be the part of this current I. How can we calculate? That is I into 10 divided by 10 plus 10, right? This is the current division rule. See it very carefully. This is the I, right? This current is divided in two parts, IN and in this part. That's why the IN is equal to I into 10 divided by 10 plus 10. It is 4 upon 3 into 10 upon 20. It is 2 upon 3 ampere. Now apply the formula of Norton's theorem, that is IL, right? Current through the load resistor is equal to IN into Rn divided by Rn plus Rn, right? This one is also a current division rule. How can we calculate IL? that is In, that is 2 upon 3 into Rn, it's so 15 divided by Rn, that is 15 plus RL, RL is 5. Right? After the solving, it become that is IL is equal to 2 upon 3 into 15 upon 20, that is 3 upon 4, and finally it is 0.5 ampere. 0.5 ampere is the current, is the value of load current passing through this load resistor for this particular circuit by the Norton's theorem. Right? This is all about the example of Norton's theorem. Now see the numerical based on Norton's theorem. Using Norton's theorem, find the current in the branch AB containing 6 ohm resistor. Right? So for the solution of this circuit with the help of Norton's theorem, it is necessary to convert these voltage sources into an equivalent current sources. Okay. This one is a 4.5 volt, it becomes a current source having the value of 4.5 divided by 4 ampere. And this 4 ohm is here in parallel with the current source. Right? Okay. Now convert this voltage source into an equivalent current source. So it is 3 divided by 5 ampere. 3 divided by 5 ampere. And 5 is here, which is in parallel with this current source. And this is the branch AV containing 6 ohm resistor. Right? Okay, after the division of 4.5 divided by 4, it become 1.125 ampere, and this one is 0.6 ampere. The direction of this current is upward, and the direction of this current is also in upward direction. So after the summation, current source become 1.125 plus 0.6, it become 1.725 ampere, a current source, right? This be the equivalent of this. Now this be the equivalent of this. Okay. There are three resistances, 4 ohm, 6 ohm and 5 ohm. See, this is the branch AB containing the resistance 6 ohm, and these two resistances are connected in parallel, so it become a single resistance, right? After the solving, it is 4 into 5 divided by 9 ohm, right? Why it is so? Because these two are connected in parallel. After the solving, it is 2.22 ohm, right? 4 into 5 divided by 9, it become 20 divided by 9, that is nothing but 2.22 ohm, right? This one is the Norton's equivalent circuit diagram for this particular circuit. Okay, now apply the Norton's theorem. So load current is nothing but Norton's equivalent current source, that is In, into fraction of resistances, that is 2.22 divided by 2.22 plus 6. What is the value of In? That is the Norton's equivalent current source. It is 1.725 into 2.22 divided by 8.2. Right? Now solve it. It become 0.466 ampere. This be the current passing through the 6 ohm resistor. I'm repeating. Listen me very carefully. This is the circuit diagram which is given to you. Right? Whatever the information over here, there are two voltage sources. One of them having 4.5 volt, other one of 3 volt. Okay? These are the three resistances. Now, according to the question, calculate the current in 6 ohm resistor. Right? Say it is IL. Okay? First of all, I am going to convert these voltage sources into the equivalent current sources. And equivalent current sources. One of them is 1.125 ampere in parallel with 4 ohm. Other one having the current of 0.6 ampere in parallel with 5 ohm. Okay. The direction of these two currents is in upper direction. So we can add 1.125 with 0.6. It become 1.725 ampere, which is nothing but Norton's equivalent current source. Okay. This 4 ohm and 5 ohm are connected in parallel. So its equivalent is 2.22 ohm, which is in parallel with the 6 ohm that is in the branch AB. Okay. Now the current in this branch AB, that is a 6 ohm resistor, IL is equal to whatever the value of equivalent Norton's current source into fraction of resistances. It is 1.725 into 2.22 divided by 2.22 plus 6, it become 8.22. Finally, after the solving, the load current passing through the 6 ohm resistor or in the branch AB, it is nothing but 0.466 ampere. Now see the next. Find the Norton's equivalent circuit at terminals X and Y for the given circuit diagram. Circuit diagram contains voltage source of 30 volt, resistance is 20 ohm, this point is X, resistance 10 ohm, this one is another voltage source having the voltage value of 18 volt, right? This is the another point Y. Find the Norton's equivalent circuit at terminals X and Y, right? Okay. So in the Norton's theorem, it is necessary to convert voltage sources into the corresponding current sources. See, this one is a current source for this voltage source. It is 30 divided by 20. This one is the voltage, this one is the resistance. It becomes 1.5 ampere. Right? This source having value 1.5 ampere, and that this resistance 20 ohm is here in parallel with the current source. Right, this is the point X, this is then the point Y. Now convert this voltage source into corresponding current source. 18 divided by 10, it is 1.8 ampere. Right? Okay. Where is this resistance? This one 10 ohm resistance, it is over here in parallel with the 1.8 ampere. Now the direction of these currents is same, is in same direction. So it is 1.5 and 1.8. It become 3.3 ampere. Right? This is the value of current source I in. That is nothing but Norton current, right? here Rn. How can we calculate Rn? These two resistances are in connected in parallel. So the value of Rn is given by the formula. Rn is equal to 20 into 10 divided by 20 plus 10. It become 200 divided by 30. That is 6.67 ohm. So this one is known as the Norton's equivalent circuit for this particular circuit, right? This one is the Norton's equivalent circuit having the value of current source, that is 3.3 ampere, and Rn as 6.67 ohm.